Hi. Welcome. It's going to be a little bit long, 1 hour plus minus. And it's about a new concept of being equal shareholders to make people to be stronger in the community and in the society they are living in, specifically as customers in front of the 1% owning most of the production. The goal of all this is a new stock market regulation in which equal ownership is respected. First, you can get all this information by searching "Yes, I'm angry" in Google, and you don't need to look at me. If you want to look at me, maybe I would be helpful in explaining all the thing. What we can do is the 99% in front of the 1%. Anyone, as a customer, not as a worker, can cooperate with other in the same level to get power bigger than the political power. Power as equal owner over something. So now we go step by step to understand the thing. We can, some individuals in some place can sign agreement of being like equal shareholders. We will get into that and understand how the group protect itself versus the individual, and the individual protect himself or herself in front of the group. It's a balanced agreement. And these people will sign the agreement. They will send the number of the people, the email of the group, what they want to boycott, and how much money they spend there regularly to someone else. And this someone else will wait and then... What? Okay. Will send to someone else. This someone else will wait and analyze the data until reaching, let's say, 30%, meaning 30% of some marketing chain like Lidl will be of those that sign this agreement of being equal shareholders. And after reaching this threshold, the one will send back to the people, boycott now. The people will boycott for some time. The one will send someone else and say, to negotiate with this little and say, okay, you are boycotted now for 30%. This is the agreement they sign now. Someone else will come and say, you know, those people, they want 20% of your business. And someone else will come and say, you know, we didn't publish it yet. They didn't publish it yet. But they're going to publish this information in a week from now. This is the address to reply if you want to negotiate about 20% of your business. To be owned by those that signed the agreement of being equal shareholders over your business. Otherwise, 30% of the volume you market now will somehow move to another competitor of you, little or I don't know what. So, now, you can say, he is crazy, people will not do this. What? How many people you need? It's not possible. So I will try to convince you that it's possible. So let's go step by step. If we will put it in the media, maybe the media will say, will someone controlling the media will suppress it. So we should create it in a in alternative media to keep the information out. This can be by media like internet, etc., but also can be by an infotent. A normal infotent, legal, daytime infotent, running by activists or by non-activists, let's say those that want to make meditation or whatever they want. So many kind of information can be passing there, alternatively to, like in a real time, by real people in a real in a real medium, not virtual, and also those agreements and what we talk about can pass there in those infotent. So those infotent is a chain of infotent having their own mailing list, having their own structure, can already maintain regular marketing of people, please, can, would you consider to sign the agreement, tra-la-la-la, for boycotting, tra-la-la. This, no one can stop. Not no one can stop. Everyone that try to stop will just generate it bigger. Now let me talk about another theoretical thing. In like I'm an activist, and in the theory of activism, there is the question of dilemma. As an activist, your purpose is to push the dilemma to the other side, so that the police or the people that you approach, they will start to have question and you have the answer. You push the dilemma to the other side. When you lose, you have dilemma and you are split. When you win, the dilemma is on the other side. All the task of activism, it can be formulated in a football game when the ball is pushing the dilemma to the other side. Now, if we have this infotent, and it's legal infotent, we push the dilemma to the other side. All what we're going to do is illegal, see. Every attempt to stop it will just generate more of it itself, it will generate more publishing, etc., etc. So this is the approach of pushing the dilemma to the other side. But now let me talk about another side of activism. Normally in activism you push to the other side, but because we forgetting the critical mass we need, because we are heard only when we get the critical mass, we cannot really generate constant pressure. We can only generate short-term pressure. It's a short-wave strategy. In time, we can take capacity, but only in a short time. If we would, so think like, or I think like, there are short waves activity and there are long waves activity. Long wave mean you make strategy, you know your resources, you create your resources, and you have direction, and you go long. If you do so, you not only make a negative campaign, but positive campaign. Negative campaign belong to short wave action. You say what is not good there. On this you can make many people into it. When you have long wave, long-term action, you need to benefit the people acting for you. They need to get something while they go so long with you. This is black and white. It's just acting like this. Now, so normally what is happening, if we maintain equality in the long wave, we have cooperatives. That is how people know to do it. Now, ComComIsm or common company is the approach I try to deliver here. And it's targeting the problems we have in cooperative. So, in cooperative is good thing as long that we are in homogenic small unit. So when I know you and you know me and we are not more than some hundred people, because I cannot know more than some hundred people, then we delegate people for some task, we can rotate, etc., etc., and it can work. The problem comes when we need critical mass. Critical mass is when we don't know who make what, and we don't know when, we simply don't know nothing and just want everything to work. So the question is, when we will delegate someone to work for us, like prime minister or the head of the workers, it's the same problem. By the way, state is also kind of cooperative. It's problematic, it's the same problem. The scale create a problem here. So when we will delegate someone that we don't know and we cannot contact directly, we are in danger that this someone really will not consider the individual, the delegate, the one. And when I'm equal shareholder and executive power is there, and I'm not satisfied so much what I do, I go. When I'm in cooperative and I go, when I'm a member in a cooperative and I go, maybe I get some return value. But the value of that will be determined by the cooperative, not by me. When I'm equal shareholder, the value of what I'm going to go with will be determined by negotiation between me and someone else. So now I have power not only about myself, but also about all the other people in the cooperative, in the company cooperative. So I have 10 euro share. If I had 10 euro share and I am fucked up and I sell it in 9 euro, all the other lose in this moment 10%, including the executive power, and it's published in everyone. So this is a very critical power each individual has. So that's why equal shareholding. Equal shareholding give a win-win position for the individual. When I come in, I come because it's good. When I go out with something, it's also good. It's equal shareholding give the common interest because we are all equal shareholders, and the individual interest because I am a shareholder in the same position of equal shareholder. And it give a new power to the individual in front of the group under any scale. So, Now we need to explain how there is a exactly how this agreement create a new balance between the individual and the group, so that the group will not be getting crazy because of some individuals, especially those that want to maybe want to fuck the group, it can be, and how the group cannot pee on the individuals as the normal way they do. So ComComIsm or common ComComIsm stands for common company, like capitalism, forever, for whatever it stands, and communism or socialism, there is ComComIsm. So let's go to the points of the agreement so that we can see the balance between all the powers there, between the individual and the it's called liberty. Okay, so first, when I would sell the share to someone, the one there must agree with the 6-point agreement and must agree that it will not be changed. This already give kind of GPL ownership agreement. You cannot change the agreement. It's a GPL. It's a compromise, point. You cannot change it. You can sell it, but you cannot change it. You can transfer it, but you cannot change the DNA of the thing. The second protection is the group have criteria for accepting new individuals. Let's say the individual should not be racist, or let's say the individual should, I don't know, whatever the group will put them. This provide already definition for what kind of individual can come in. When the individual sell the share to someone else, before that, the one must ask for the price the one want to sell. The group, if the group is willing to buy it, if so, it is sold to the group. So the group is protected also by being able to be first buyer. Now, the price. This is a little bit mathematical, but please go with me. Principally, it's the range of changing the price is proportional to the power of the individual in the group. Meaning, if I have 10 euro share, and we are 10 people there, I can sell it between 11 and 9 euro. If there are 100 people, I can sell it between 10 and 1 cent or 9 and 99 cent. Multiply a constant. The constant will be a DNA of that group that will tell to some for foreigner how wild they go there, how wild they let the individual to change the value of themselves. So this give already a balance between the individual and the group. So the individual can be a person or another common company. We can have many, many layers. So, through all the layers, one cannot have more than one position. What this means, if I and you have this as a common company, and I and her have this as common company, this and this could not have as common company the table. because I would have sued another company. Why? What is good in this layering? We can begin in small units. Let's say 10 people know each other, and then we can have 10 such small common companies owning bigger common companies, etc., etc., etc. So, but we need to keep that through all the layers, one would not have more than position. In this case, when people could move between the small units, okay, but the bigger unit is okay, nothing
like happened. Fractal.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of,
mm-hmm.
It's stable.
Mm-hmm.
Only the stresses in the between the group could be contained in the group. Now I come with another thing. The value, no, can be made by Deutschmark or Euro or dollar, but can be also made by peer coin. Some value that we can evaluate. So peer coin will evaluate the value of ownership. Now, in the bigger company, those small companies can be division of the bigger company. Now, those small companies can transfer some table or some objects or some services between the division of the bigger company. This is untaxable. It is in the big company. But can evaluate those by object coins. We have peer coins and object coins. And then we can ask how many object coins equal how many peer coins of what product, service, or ownership. Still in one big company that can go bottom, top, endlessly, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
That's why recursivity, through all the layers, we should allow layers, and we should not allow multiply positions through the layers. Now come the following. So remember, we wanted to boycott little, like supermarket market, marketing of chain of marketing, and we wanted only 20% of this business. We didn't want all. How exactly we make it? So the idea is that there is a parameter called D, which stands for decentralization property of the unit. And when it's one, it means all the unit owned only by equal owner, peer owners. Less than one, it means that the percentage, like D multiplied 100, is the percentage owned by the equal owners. It can be, for example, 20%, 0.2 representing 20% only. In this case, Lidl will have 80%, the people, the customer will have 20%, but Lidl will sign the same agreement that we talk now. So Lidl will not be able to claim the agreement, etc. All the benefit that we have here will apply Lidl too. Now come another thing. Although Lidl will have 80% and the peer owner will have only 20%, Lidl cannot say how many will be the peer owners. This is number 5. The peer authority will decide the number of the peers in the group, even if it is smaller than 0.5. So So now we can make many combinations. We can not only come bottom top, but also come and hug existing companies as customers. Because politically we don't have so much power. Politically, it's actually the political arrangement we live in the masses, in the mess up of the democratic of masses, the will of the individual is not represented. Cannot be represented. The will, the wish, the what you want. Not what you want out of selection. What you want cannot be realized politically. But as a customer, we always make a choice. We buy this beer or that beer, this coffee or that coffee, this computer or that computer, whatever, we always choose as customers. So politically we have no choice. As customers we have choices that we don't want, but we implement choice making. Therefore we can make the boycotting as a power, long-term power, long-wave power, that will reflect our wishes. So back to the little, we can in this scenario, so 20% of the little are those equal shareholder, and they decide how many they will be. They can decide, we accept more people as long as the value is not reduced, so somehow the value need to go up or something like that. Let's say it just work. Now what they can do though? First, they are going to get some benefit from this little. If little have benefit, they can get it. Second, they could determine what kind of product they're going to get there as customers. Because normally you don't get what you want, And third, they can decide how the business will run. So, for example, you know, Aldi really misuse their workers, etc., etc. So, if you are equal owners of something, strange thing is happening. Suppose there are many equal owners. Normally, in capitalistical system, those that have the decision, that make the decision, are really disconnected. They are really few, and they are really far from the effect of the decision, from the result of what they decide. Now, if the customers are small equal shareholders, they are very near the effect of the decision they make. It actually affects them. Not only that, so for example, if I will be equal shareholder in some company that misuse the workers, you can come to me and say, hey, are you equal shareholder in this, in Aldi? I don't, and you will be my friend. Man, what happened to you, eh? So I will become to be, the interface will be bigger, much bigger. The interface of, that will be affected from the public opinion, from moral issues, it's something like that. So, it's better for the society. So it's better for the individual, for the group. And now, why it's better for the group? There are three parameters to ask, in my opinion. One is it good for the group, for the individual? Yeah, it's good for me, as long as the number of the people is more than what I can recognize. And it's good also in a diverse community. So if you remember, there was there were small groups owning bigger, and so one group can be, you know, opposing the other. They could never live together, but in this structure they could live. Why? Because the individuals are not for gaining the benefit of the individual. The individual do not must give everything to the small group, the one in. Everything meaning to fight against any other, but can just move to the other. So it's better to the individual, it's better for the group, and it's better for the society. Society, I said, the group, I need to say again. Okay, you might believe that equality in the group is not good for the group, but when you believe it's good, there is the following dangers. There are many worker groups or small organizations in which they are equal because it's good for the group to be equal. Why? Because, that's to explain why equality is good for the group, because each person function in more than one function, so can observe the other functioning. So because of that, there is more transparency in the group when it's more equal, and principally it will be good for more people in the group, unless it comes to such scale that there is thing non-transparent in the group, and this is because equality is good as long as it provides transparency. And for equality to provide transparency, we need to force the executive power to really deliver the transparency. Now, so it's like a team. It's when it's working, it's like a team of equal elements against another team, that they are equal in the other side. And it's also, when there is some benefit in the other side, each individual can pass to the other side. So the group must satisfy the people for them not to go to the other side. And because of the competition between the group, it makes the group to be better. So I think it's good for the individual, the group, and the out of the group, meaning the society. You remember this D, yeah? So maybe I can show, it will run here. D multiply I equals C multiply N. D is the D we talk, I is the number of shares, C is the number of peer owners, N is the number of shares per peer owner. Now, the D is unchangeable. And we agree in the 6 points that can never be changed, that the D is unchangeable in static ComCom called SComCom. But is changeable in DComCom or IComCom. So, need concentration here. If we are partner, we the equal owner, the customers, partnering with company like Lidl, foreigner for us, we need the D to be unchangeable, because we don't want that somehow they will make some people somehow. That suddenly the scenario can be that Lidl will begin with 200,000 people and say, okay, Now you need to be 2 million, but for that we have number 5. We say the number of us will be the same with us. But they can say another thing. Well, now they didn't need to be 10% and not reflect 10% and not 20%. Like reduce your power for some reasons. Or have another partner in you or many, they can make many suggestions. And they can force for those suggestions by many ways. So the D is static with such. Static meaning all, including the all the owners, including the Aldi, the little, they will sign that they will not change the D. But it can be also dynamic in a in the ComCom or in the DComCom, dynamic ComCom, but with some regulation. The first regulation is that the I would like to show you something before so you can see it in your own eyes. Because in our story, we have 20% belong to the customers and 80% belong to Lil. So the Lil is in the blue position and the customer in the red position. And it looks like that. This is S-ComCom in our story. So the D is unable to be, is static, can never be changed. But in dynamic ComCom, a new owner, a newcomer, can enter only by first being equal owner, and only after that having other equal owners and owning part of the blue position. And it looks like that. So now people from outside,
hold it straight up please.
People from outside came together and formed a new position inside. And this position inside, they all together own something in the blue. So back to understand this, we can like someone that entered the company, a new owner, can come directly to the blue or not, meaning not first to the red and then form with other red another position in the blue. The second option is for DComCom and ICComCom. The first option is for SComCom. So someone, when the D is static, someone can go from outside and own position in the blue. But in a DComCom, one cannot directly go to the blue position, but must first find other red, friend in other red position, and form with them a new position in the blue. Then the number of shares is as the number of the members in the blue or the, in the red. And by the movement of them, the D is changing automatically. So we add two other parameters. We say, first, regulation, that one, one coming into the ComCom must first become peer owner, and only by other peer owner can get into the ordinary ownership. And the other is the number of shares is as the number of people in any position. So in this scenario, it might be if the number of shares each peer has n will be 1, the number of shares in the outer of each peer owner in the outer will be 1, if that would be, there will be no interest to come inside. If it will be less than 1, we will have, the people will have interest to go inside. So I will repeat again. If the number of shares each peer owner in the ComCom is 1 and it's the ComCom, then there is no interest for the peers to form an inner ComCom to own the blue position. If it's less than 1, then they have interest to go and to get something bigger than less than 1, so some benefit. So how much will be n, how many shares, fractal of shares, each peer owner will have, will be decided by the peer authority, which is the same one, which is only the peers, same like how that decide how many there will be. So it is those in the weak position that decide how many there will be and how much shares they will, how many shares they will have. So the difference between DCOMCOM and ICOMCOM is ICOMCOM do not allow to sell the share to outer individuals, only to the group, and DCOMCOM allow. So DCOMCOM is dynamic and open, and ICOMCOM is in DCOMCOM and is closed. You can sell in any price, etc., by all those definitions, but only to the group. Now, of course, if it's only to the group, there is monopolization of the price of the group, but from the other side, there is protection from attacking the group. So, I repeat, there are three kind of ComCom: S-ComCom, D-ComCom, I-ComCom. S-ComCom static, in which the D is defined once and never can be changed. D-ComCom and I-ComCom, the D is changing, but the entry is only to the position of the red, and the number of shares per peer is decided by the peers. The ComCom, the individual can sell the share to foreigner and to the group, but first to the group, and ICOMCOM, the individual can sell only to the group, cannot sell to the foreigner. So, yeah, so this is all what we need to agree, but it's open many opportunities. We can form it down to up, we can be attached to other existing, it can be an agreement in genossenschaft or union, And it's empowering the individual in the group versus other group, because it's making competition versus other groups. So I want you to see it. For example, you have two groups, yeah? And suppose they normally, two groups can fight, yeah? On some other things. Normally when they fight and the finger cannot jump away to another hand, then they will fight until one will swallow the other. But imagine that the finger can go and suddenly more, he will have three fingers and another two fingers pass to another hand. Imagine such a thing. So it means that two individuals in this, from those five, thought it's better for them to be in the group, in the other group, and the other group agree that it's bad, that they want the other. In this case, the fight was not causing to swallow one the other, it was not fight until the bitter end. It was just the group really worked for the individuals until the group could not work better than the other group. So the individual, like customer, went to the other group, but they are not customer, they are owner of it. Another thing that I want to say, as customers, what is common between those that buy beers? Not so much. Where is the solidarity between those that buy beer? Not big solidarity. There is not so much common interest between them. So customers lack solidarity or common interest. So that's why they cannot so much, again, short and long wave. They can be on short wave boycotting something for the cheese of some place for some days, for short time. But they cannot maintain, it's hard to maintain policy, etc., for long term by boycotting. Again, because we didn't benefit those that are doing the activity, but in ComComIsm you can. By being equal shareholder, you are also able to benefit. Therefore, the protest can become not only shortwave and not only negative, but positive, and allow people to get benefit from that. And you can integrate those that have not so much in common, because they can care for themselves and they are not go until the bitter end, we are one with the other. And so it's not boycotting until the bitter end, it's not boycotting for moral values, it's boycotting for gaining better position in life of the customers. Now, another theoretical thing, sorry. The 99% are on the other side of 1% owning more than half of the resources. This is fact, 1% or less. Now, they are, if you define them as workers, you will find many groups that are competing one against the other. So for example, just to all the maps through workers or classes are maps that divide to smaller and smaller groups, not unite for critical mass. The map of customer do so, because normally people, as consumer, they will not fight so much against the other customer, whatever, but they have the same experience there. And we, as activists, we don't use this experience to unite them. It's kind of dead field for activists to approach the people by what they consume and to give them benefit by what they consume and to create any solidarity between people as such by what they consume. So it's a new map. It's a map of the Occupy movement. It's not the map of classes, that say there are many levels. It's not the map of race or of nation. It's the map of costuming versus owning of production. And costumers, customers can force becoming equal owners over the sellers in some parts, in some coexisting. That's it for now. Thank you for watching.